belong to my council members Westler, Webb, Massey, Kramer, and Collins, and is dated December 21st, 2011.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise and ask this body for unanimous consideration of Local Law 11-7. This is a local law to effect the prohibition of natural gas and petroleum exploration and extraction activities, underground storage of natural gas, and disposal of natural gas and petroleum extraction, exploration, and production wastes. We have to do a seeker. That's right. And in this seeker declaration, we want to declare the possibility of one single business going to affect a great economic change in the positive in a variety of ways, but rather it will only lead to economic development of a small, simple area, specified area, that of oil and natural gas production, and when that is done, it will go away. I don't believe that the ancillary businesses will occur. I believe that for a short time, that yes, hotels and restaurants and other things like that will see an increase. But I don't believe that that increase will be needed out in other factors, other sections of economic growth and development. We in the city of Binghamton are looking towards the future, in the 21st century, being a lean, green machine. We want to make Binghamton a place where green technology is the forefront. The new technology of the 21st century is green technology. Binghamton stands in that place to be that driving force. Southern Tier stands to be in that place to be that driving force. Effecting a ban on this right now for a period of 2 years does not impede the ability of natural gas production in the future. What it does is it allows other types of businesses and the city and everything else to create plans and such in order to grow and develop in other ways as well. And at the same time, we can then have more dialogue and more discussion and get better knowledge of actual good solid fracking, good solid well development, good solid DEC and oversight. These things are the important parts that need to happen that are missing now. Those things are missing now. And so we, as the city fathers and mothers and brothers and sisters and everyone in, okay, to be as politically correct as possible, have to look not at the now all the time. We have to look at the future and how everything is affected, And putting a ban now will help the city of Binghamton be stronger, be better, and I ask for this body's unanimous support. I do want to say that I appreciate everybody who came down from the anti-ban side, coming down and voicing their opinion. They're strong, they're heartfelt, they're respected, and I know that I'm a pragmatic. I know that fracking will probably occur somewhere in New York State. I want it done well. I want it done right. I want it done safely. I've got an aquifer in the city of Binghamton, the largest, if not the largest, in the first ward that needs to be protected at all costs. At all costs. Okay? And one of the things that we've got to look at is not what's going to happen in the next, the gentleman's a half generation of good jobs and growth. That's 10 years. I don't have the luxury of looking for only 10 years of growth and development. I need to be looking at something that's 50 and 60 years of growth and development. That's what I need to be looking at, and that doesn't afford me that. So I ask you to put the ban down. 2 years later, we can have this discussion again. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. I hate to disagree with the mayor and council member, but I do not believe that we've had sufficient notice to the residents. This, and there's nothing wrong with this being political. This is political, and there's nothing wrong with that. But this has been rushed through at the end of the year, when 71% of this council turns over in 10 days. So I'm going to make a motion that we hold this over. Their in the areas where they live, in their homes, both
people who were in favor of the ban and people who were opposed came and spoke respectfully, intelligently, and engaged in public debate in a way that I think we all are inspired by and hope will continue beyond, you know, this group of people's turn. I listened to everything that was said and I took some notes. And I wanted to summarize just so that people understand that this was, that listening did occur and this is a thoughtful decision on my part. These issues came up in favor of the ban. The environmental impact is profound, both locally, regionally, and worldwide, and that we are responsible as shepherds of our earth and our communities to protect that. The impact on infrastructure and crime is something that was repeatedly mentioned by people, by the speakers, that we are unprepared for the kind of impact that this industry will have, that it has been demonstrated to be destructive in other communities, and that this will is something that needs to be considered. And then finally, the discussion of the economic impact, and it's interesting because the economic impact was talked about on both sides of this argument. But there is an argument for sustainable economic development, not to build a community's economic future around one industry. This community has a long and complicated history with industry. And as somebody said earlier, I think very well, we didn't know that the former industries were going to leave. We had this idea of a paternalistic industry coming and taking care of us and looking for our future and preserving our families and our communities. And they did for a very long time. And then, for you know, fate had it, they left, and in some cases left well, and we didn't suffer other than economically, but in some cases they kind of salted the earth when they left. And we're still dealing with that. And as a council, we've been dealing with brownfield cleanup. And the cost of that is phenomenal. And it's one of the burdens that we as taxpayers are dealing with as well. Now, these issues came up against the ban, and they're very real as well. That there is some economic sacrifice that's being made by saying no to this industry, that it would be a boom, it would bring economic growth to this community, it would bring jobs, it would bring people spending money. And that, you know, this is something that is going to be hard to turn down because we're economically depressed. We're in bad shape, or we have been for a while. I think that we're actually improving and on an upswing. But it's understandable that people in this community would want this kind of thing. It's too appealing. Another argument that was made was that this is a redundant law, that there's already protection, and that it's legally suspect. There is the idea that this law is based on fear or simply bad science, that the science isn't really supporting what we're claiming, folks in favor of claiming, and that we should read the studies more closely and do more research because we find out that it's actually a safe and clean way to do business. Okay, so I listened to those arguments, and I want to talk about three things. One is the research. The point about the environment. staff, as somebody mentioned earlier, is still going to be here in 2 years. But a poison water source will be here forever. And so the conservative view on this is to, you know, let's ban it. Let's stop. Let's wait. We don't know. And if we don't know, then we don't want to start doing this. Because, again, we also have lots of evidence of industries that we didn't know that much about. We went forward with. And now we're dealing with the consequences of it, not just locally, but across the country and globally. Cleanup is expensive and sometimes impossible. Finally, my last point is about the economy, the economic boom. This administration and this council has spent numerous hours and projects working on sustainable economic development. The Commission on Downtown Development is about sustainable economic development. And the idea of putting all of our eggs in one industry, and then knowing that that industry has a pretty short half-life, that we're making, ironically, but the idea that we may actually, you know, find the end of this and then be back where we were when our two big benefactors left, seems irresponsible. We need to continue the work we've been doing towards sustainable economic development. We need to continue the work we've been doing towards the green economy. We need to find other sustainable investments and development in this community. And we need to keep this place safe for our children. Thank you.
I guess it's me, and I've really been avoiding this. I walked in here tonight firmly undecided. I've spent a great deal of time over the course of the last couple of weeks reading everything I can get my hands on, talking to people. I tried to read, I've read some of the studies that were forwarded to us from both sides of the issue. And then I went out and I tried to read some of some things that I thought were maybe a little more neutral, you know, not coming from one side or the other. And I still walked in here tonight firmly undecided and really torn by this. This is probably one of the most difficult votes that I'm going to take. I want to say, first of all, you know, the talk about politics, I think for a lot of people, in this room, this is definitely a political statement. This is about making a political statement. For me, I don't feel that it is that way, because I honestly, legitimately see both sides of the argument. And in fact, I spent some time on the phone with some of my, and in person with some of my colleagues, trying to argue one side or the other of the argument to see if I could be persuaded. And I want to say that the speaker who came down here tonight, who summed up exactly what I was feeling, and I wish she was still here because I want to know how much I appreciate what she said, was Amy Shapero, when she talked about the difficulty of this decision, about originally thinking, wow, this is going to be the thing that's going to be the economic savior for all of us, and then looking at the other side of it and saying, but there's these other things that need to be considered. I also want to say that I, too, appreciated hearing from everyone on both sides of the issue. Although I am going to be honest and say, because I don't tend to hold back, I am going to be honest and say that I did resent the implication that those of us sitting around this table don't know anything about this issue and haven't done our homework and are reacting from that place. Because I'm here to tell you, it's factually inaccurate, at least for me. And so I did resent that. I want to say that I spent a great deal of time talking with Assemblywoman Donna Ricardo about this over the last few days. And the reason that I contacted her was because I know that she has been very involved, and I know that she too is sort of looking at the benefits and the pros and the cons. And so I knew that I could get some information. And she told me today, which I thought was really interesting, that the state has actually hired a consultant at this point to examine more of the social implications of this, the economic effects on housing, on crime, and things like that, and because they know from the research that they've done, that the DC has done and that other groups have done, that there are going to be these don't have enough information. That made me a little uncomfortable. But then I looked at the other side of it and I said, you know, I am a, you know, a peaceful hawk on this board and always have a bed, and I'm going to look for any place where we can get some money. And this would be a great, this does have the potential to be a great economic boom. And I don't want, you know, like my argument with some of my colleagues was, if we could just, you know, even if it only lasts 10 years, if we could use that 10 years to really work hard to diversify our economy. But I'm not sure that that's a strong enough argument, because I'm not sure that that when we look at the costs along with the boom, that it's going to really balance out and allow us to have the resources that we need to move forward and diversify our economy. I wanted to say to one of the other speakers who came forward and said, you know, they wanted to use the joint sewage treatment plant as their example of, we should leave it to the experts. We did leave it to the experts, and that's what we got. So I did want to point that out. In that case, we did leave it to the people who were the supposed experts. I'm not completely comfortable with this. I'm a business owner. I'm not completely comfortable with saying we're going to ban any particular thing. But another one of the speakers towards the end talked about us working together and sharing ideas and finding a way to move forward in a positive way. And I guess the conclusion that I've come to tonight is that this 2 years buys us the time to do that. It buys us the time to make sure that the science is good. It buys us the time to make sure that for all of the interested parties to come to the table and figure out how we do this right. I am not against gas drilling. I actually do think that if done properly, it can really be a great thing for our community. I think what this local law does is gives us a couple of years in which to make sure that we do it properly. So as difficult as the decision as this is going to be, I think that I'm going to have to go ahead and support it.
Thank you. Well, everybody knows it's going to be 6-1. This evening. I just want to say that it's a real luxury. I had a council member, one of our council members here, tell me two very interesting things. One of the things that I was told was that really, the real motivation is an all-out ban. So really this, I appreciate Councilwoman Renia, you know, saying that she would like to work and work towards some type of, you know, best practices. But really, the motivation for probably the majority of the people on this council is just an all-out ban. It has nothing to do with the two-year moratorium. And also, I was told by the same council member that it doesn't really matter what the residents of the city of Danville think if you feel that you have right on your side, that states to me, that's kind of Machiavellian. So I have to disagree in that area. I don't know where this idea that natural gas would be the only industry here. I agree with Councilwoman Renia that economic benefits that we could get from natural gas could help us diversify. It could give us sales tax money, it could give us money for our schools, to improve our schools. I don't know where these pie in the sky ideas that all of a sudden we're going to have thousands of green jobs in the city of Binghamton. I've been on city council for 7 years. I don't see thousands of jobs. I see less jobs. I see less people. We barely held down. We barely kept even since the last census. When I was a kid, there was 85,000 people in the city of Binghamton. So it's nice to take the high ground here and pretend that the Chamber of Commerce means nothing. That people who have invested millions of dollars in businesses in this community who are in favor of natural gas exploration in this county mean nothing. because we have right on our side. You know, it's just amazing that over the last 3 years we've done nothing. All of a sudden, this is like the most important thing that has to happen to city council in the last month of this council. 5 of the 7 members are gone. What's the hurry? What's the rush?
However, when we continue to take an approach approach that, well, it's not in our area of library care, that too leads to a lot of the challenges that we've had in our community and has, in essence, created challenges with economic development and community health issues. Our responsibility as a city council is comprehensive. We do multitask. We do focus on neighborhood safety. We are doing a lot of work on economic development, especially as Councilman Nancy talked about with the Downtown Commission, also working with other community partners, but also the regional councils that were established under the current administration that have projects in our area, in the southern tier, that the impetus behind it is to create a diversified plan for regional development. To speak to